our annual fundraising dinner. Please join us, and we'll have a special guest with us that day. And that guest is standing beside me. You know him as Superfan, and his name is Mr. Nav Bhatia. And he wants to announce something important. On December 3rd at 9 p.m., CBC is going to launch the Nav Bhatia story, and he will tell you more about it, but it's not just his story, as he says, it's all of our stories. So without further ado, Mr. Nav Bhatia.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum. Very good. Thank you very much again for welcoming and inviting me to this mosque. I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm among my brothers. So if I stumble, please forgive me. I'm here. I think all of you have seen me at the Raptors game. I represent you all. I just don't go there myself. I represent us all people. And Allah has been very kind to me. I came here in 84 after the genocide with Sikhs in India. I came with nothing, just a lot of commitment to my Almighty, and came here, had a very tough, had a lot of speed bumps in my life, but I just want to say that we go through a lot of speed bumps, but if we believe in our Allah, we don't change. Yes, we are different. We wear hijabs, we wear turbans. Be proud of it. Our religion, our culture is so rich, and that's what I did. I promised when I was 16 years old, I'm 17 now, and when I was 16 years old, I promised my mother called me, you know, I was young and I was entering the university, and my mom asked me, and this is for every kid who is watching me now or hearing me now or you're online. It's very important. This might change your life too. It changed mine. My mother asked me for 3 promises. She says, you won't drink. And as you all know, we Sikhs are known for, you know, we are number one in that, shamefully. But my mother asked me at that time, you won't drink. Promise me you won't drink, you won't smoke, and you won't cut your hair and take your turban off. And I said, yes. And in 84, when I came here, I'm a mechanical engineer, but I couldn't get a job because nobody wanted to hire a Sikh guy with a turban and beard. But I didn't give up. I did janitorial job. I cleaned the toilets because I had a basement for $340 in Malton, which I had to pay the rent. And like Muslims and Sikhs, we are very proud people. We don't do this, but we believe in the dignity of labor. So I did that, and after that, after 300 interviews, I got a job as a car salesman in Rexdale Hyundai. And the very first day, I'm sharing this thing for a reason with you, to tell you that believe in, you are blessed to be born in Islamic, in a Muslim religion. Be proud of that. And I was born as a Sikh. And my mother asked me those promises. A lot of my friends at that time said, hey, you know, you won't get a job unless you cut your hair and you take the turban off. I didn't do that. Let me tell you, very first day I went to the Rexdale job as a car salesman, people called me everything. Towel head, turban head, underwear head, diaper head. Didn't bother me. But on that day, I prayed to my Almighty and said, give me strength. And I told myself, I have to be better than good if I want to survive. And you know what? With Allah's grace, I sold 127 cars at that time in 84 in the first 3 months. It was a record then, and it still is a record today. Yeah, it still is a record today. And rest is all. Then I became a manager, and I became a general manager. And, you know, God is so good. You know, when you believe in yourself, if you're truthful to Allah, Allah will look after you. I can tell you that. I vouch for it. Allah will look after you. But you have to believe in completely. No diluting it. know this and know that, justifying this and justifying. No. So now I'm very blessed. You know, with the Raptors, you have seen me. First time somebody was made the Grand Marshal of the parade. First time somebody was made the super fan with a turban and beard. There was a lot of pushback. But you know what? We went going. We went going. We were also given the Grand Marshal of the biggest sports parade. We were also given this championship ring, which is the first time in this world on any sports that a fan has been given a championship ring. It's because of Allah. He looks after His kids. If you believe in them, you know, you have seen kids playing around their mother and father, a father, and the kids do all kind of things, you know, but they make sure, they keep on watching that my father is watching me. They do things. You watch that. You're yourself a father, because they know that their father has their back. They will look after them. After that, first one, with God's grace, to get the to be inducted in the Hall of Fame. This is the turban they made fun of. Now this turban is in the Hall of Fame for the next 300 years, 400 years. It will be there. My jersey is there. And you know what my mom is in the heaven saying? I'm proud of you, son. You kept your promise. I'm proud of you. Because I kept those promises to my mother. That's why it happened. You know, I can't believe that somebody will make a movie on me. CBC, first time again in the history, they are making a movie on a brown guy, on a Sikh guy, which is coming on the television on CBC at 9 p.m. next Friday. Make sure you watch it, because each one of you will feel that it's a movie about you. I have some girls with, you know, I promote the girls to wear hijab when they come to the game. I tell them to wear hijabs. We did a Muslim day in the game. We had 2,000 people and thousands of girls with hijab. I love that. Be proud of your identity. Don't dilute it. You are blessed. So, when you watch this movie, you will see some girls with hijab playing basketball and promoting the hijab. I want everybody to watch that. The movie is now going to be shown in Canada. Next year, it will be on Netflix or Amazon or somebody else, somewhere else big, and everybody will watch it, you know, in the whole world. I'm just trying to let everybody know that there is a strength in diversity. This is a strength in diversity. And it is. That's why I'm in front of you today. You think if I would have drank or if I would have broken my promise to mother, I would be standing here in front of you? They will be making a movie on me? No. Prime Minister Trudeau has been inspired so much by the clips that next Wednesday on December the 1st, he's sharing this movie with every parliamentarian in Ottawa. Amazing. All I'm requesting you is, please, please watch this, tell your friends about it, and let's make this world a better place. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.